Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video we'll again talk about terrain generation, but this time completely for free. 2 weeks ago I showed you a method of creating landscapes using Gea, but this workflow can cost you up to $300. So right after I started searching for free alternatives. There are two ways we can go about creating landscapes, either fully in Blender using for example the AMT landscape add-on, or third-party software. I tried both and settled for a Python program that implements hydraulic erosion. You can download the GitHub repository in the description. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said, let's get straight into the video. To follow along with this tutorial, you will also need Anaconda, which allows you to create Python environments with which we can easily use our program. Right now, I'm in the Conda Navigator, which for me is the best way to manage my environments. So, to start our Python program and create our height map, we first want to create a new environment. So, give it a new name and click Create. Now, by pressing this little play button, you can open the terminal using this environment. Now, let's type in Python, and you can see that right now we are running Python 3.7. But we actually want Python 3.6 because this is what works best together with the repository we just downloaded. So, hit Ctrl and Z, enter, and type in conda install python equals 3.6. This way Python 3.6 will be installed in this environment. And now if we again type in Python and hit enter, you can see that we're running 3.6. Now let's unzip the repository. Into this tutorial we will only work with the river network file. This file will generate a noise pattern and erode it, and we can output this result to a grayscale map. To adjust the resolution, we can open the file in Notepad or in any text editor you like, scroll down until we find our main function, and right here we can change our resolution. Right now this is set to 512, and this is what I'm going to keep it at for this tutorial, but you can of course set it higher. Just be aware, this is nowhere near real time, so for example creating a 4K map can even take hours on your machine. Now, if you want to use an input map, you can use the simulation.py, but this one takes a much longer time and you will also need to modify the code. And I will probably make a follow-up tutorial for just showing you how to do this. Okay, now we can switch back to our terminal and locate our repository. Now we can type in Python space and then river underscore network.py. This will start our Python file. But you can now see that we are missing modules, the first one being NumPy, so we can just type in pip install and NumPy, and then NumPy will be installed. Great, now let's copy the command from before, paste it in, and start our file. And you can see that we are missing matplotlib. So also install this. And again, let's try to run our Python file. And we are missing SkyPy. So you probably know what to do now. Just type in pip install and SkyPy. Okay, last but not least, we are missing SKImage. But just typing in pip install SKImage won't help because we have to type in scykit-image. Okay, and now we can finally run our river network. Okay, the generation process is now done, and you can see that it has created this river underscore network.npz file. Right now, we will only need to convert this one into a grayscale map. So, just type in, again, Python, and then we will use the make grayscale image Python file and use the river underscore network.npz file as our first argument. And now we will have to define the file name for our output file, and this is going to be for me out.tiff. So let's hit enter, and now our height map has generated. Just for comparison, this was a height map created with the simulation.py file. It works relatively the same. You can also go into the code and change your dimension size right here to generate larger terrains, and then just run it the same way as we did with the river network file. And I personally actually like this height map a bit more. So we will continue the rest of this tutorial using this one. Okay, right now there's basically only one step left, and this is to texture our terrain. In my last terrain tutorial, I showed you how to do this in Mixer, but we are missing all the maps, like for example the flow map, which allow us to create more realistic terrain textures. So, how do we get them? Well, for this we can actually use the ANT landscape add-on. Just delete everything and add in a landscape. You can see that by pressing N and going to create, we have a landscape eroder. I personally don't really like the results you get from that. This is why I used this Python program to create the height map. But we can use this eroder to add, for example, the flow map to our terrain. To do this, we have to add a terrain and then delete it in edit mode, so we still have the object left. Now let's add in a plane and subdivide it a few times. Let's now go over to the modifier panel and add in a displace modifier with our height map as the texture. We can also smooth it out. Now the strength is a bit too high for me, so I'm gonna turn it down to 0.75. And now we can apply it and click on eroder. I won't change any settings right here. Let's just go to the vertex groups. You can see that all the maps we need for texturing were generated, but we only have them as vertex groups. This is not really ideal because we can't export them. This is where another free Blender add-on comes into place, which is called Tissue. With Tissue, you can just select a vertex weight group, for example the capacity one, and click on Convert to Colors. This way, the vertex group will be converted into a vertex color group. Let's give our object a new material, and under Input and Vertex Color, let's add in the Capacity Value node. By using a color ramp to clamp it, and an emission shader to display it, we can actually render out all these maps. To do this, just add in a camera, clear out the rotation, move it upwards, and use a 1:1 ratio, for example 1024, and the orthographic perspective with a scale of 2. Now you can just export these maps and use them to texture your terrain. And yeah, now you can follow the part of my old tutorial to texture the terrain using the maps we created in Blender. I hope this tutorial was helpful and I hope you learned something, and we will see you in the next video next Saturday.